大家好，今天的第42集，无论如何，我们要跟大家聊聊钾肥，还有雨水带来钾肥流失的问题，应该怎么来选择有效对抗雨水淋洗的钾肥。影片的后面，我们也会来看看钾肥从开采到加工的过程是怎么样的。钾肥的种类非常多，也有不同的等级，外观通常会随着加工的程度而不同，常看到的有粉状、晶体等等。氧化钾也就是我们肥料中钾存在的形式，它在水的溶解度非常的好，每100毫升的水可溶解35克的氧化钾，用尿素的数字来一起对比，大概是它的三倍。所以复合肥当中大量元素的氮肥跟钾肥，它们的流失率都非常高。我们来比较一下不同钾肥种类的差异。这个表格里面的左边的四栏是市面上最常看到的钾肥种类，硫酸钾跟硝酸钾的水溶性很好，水肥中的钾都会用到这两个原料。氯化钾比较好加工，而且它的含钾率也是最高的，可以高达 60% 以上。磷酸异钾也是水溶性极好的钾肥，最常当作高磷钾水肥来做叶面肥，但是价格也比较高。所以面对极端气候，农户在选择肥料时候有很大的成本压力。市面上有一种加工型的钾，使用细铝酸盐来做吸附加工，这个钾肥能够同时跟大量元素、中微量元素去做复配，解决雨天后作物营养恢复的问题。最大好处是我们不再担心流失率的问题。这种加工型的钾肥都经过实验室和田间的验证，比如说我们做了大雨淋洗的模拟试验，来验证土壤中养分流失的情况。在大雨时或大雨过后，土壤水分饱和度很高，根系处于逆境当中，要很快地将营养补充到位。事先埋在土壤里的这种肥料能就近并及时地补充，相对大雨后再去做根系施肥，不但妨碍根系恢复，表面施肥效果慢，且还有被大雨淋洗的风险。这也是为什么大力丸钾肥在雨季使用的好处能特别受到大家的认可。这个是田间实际测量的结果，以学识方式埋的大力丸，经由连续四天的大豪雨312毫米淋洗后，仍维持高 EC 值，同时养分往外扩散半径，让根系更容易吸收养分。这也表示大力丸更有效，更精准地释放养分给作物利用，抗淋洗且养分不流失。刚刚提到大力丸钾肥在土壤做了钾元素的储备，对一些容易受到雨水导致果皮水伤的作物，包括木瓜、苦瓜、凤梨，因为钾离子对于细胞修复跟物质离子进出细胞的通透性有非常大的关系，给受伤的根系做修复，然后快速补充到钾肥。在梅雨季节，尤其是南方每年的5到6月都有很多强降雨，加上期8月份沿海一带也都会有台风的影响，那使用钾肥的话，尤其是在7、8月份，在柑橘类的膨果期或者5、6月份的芒果成熟度上，使用具有对付流失率的钾肥就能够及时补充得上。钾肥是珍贵的矿物资源，但也不是取之不尽、用之不竭的。任何的矿物元素都历经千万年的沉积而来，但短短不到100年间，人类的开采已经给它们的存量带来重大危机。更显而易见的，这些养分到了田间的最大去处，竟然不是作物本身，而是带给了地球土壤、河川等环境的二次伤害。在满足作物钾肥需求的同时，同时也能对环境负责。马来西亚大力丸钾肥系列，让你做正确和对果园、对环境负责任的选择。节目结束前，让我们到全球最大的钾肥出口国加拿大，去看看 Nutrien 公司是如何开采和加工氯化钾的吧。今天的报告就到这里，我们下次见。
Let's begin our tour at the service shaft, which connects surface operations to the ore body about 1 kilometer underground. A large industrial elevator, called the cage, carries people, supplies, and even vehicles and mining equipment to underground operations. It travels at roughly 400 meters per minute, moving the length of a football field in about 15 seconds. A trip down the shaft is like a journey through time, with each layer of rock representing hundreds of thousands of years of deposits. When you reach the mine area, the rock around you is nearly 400 million years old, and the natural temperature is a constant 27 degrees Celsius, or 81 degrees Fahrenheit, even in the middle of a Canadian winter. Underground operations have roads, vehicles, offices, electrical stations, and repair shops. Vehicles designed for safety and energy efficiency transport workers from the service shaft to active mining areas, often dozens of kilometers away. Our highly trained team studies the depth, shape, and thickness of a deposit, identifying the safest and most efficient ways to access the ore body. Innovative technologies continue to improve the way we mine and enhance the safety of underground workers. At the rock face, powerful potash boring machines cut wide tunnels to extract ore from the deposit. A typical mine will have a number of borers operating at different locations to be able to produce a continuous supply of ore to feed the processing mill. As the borer advances, a series of conveyors carry the raw ore to underground storage areas until it can be hoisted to the surface for milling. Large bucket containers, called skips, carry the ore to the surface. As one skip is being filled at the bottom of the shaft, a second skip is dumping ore at the top in a continuing cycle that takes about 90 seconds to complete. Once the ore reaches the mill, we begin the process of transforming it into plant-ready fertilizer. Milling can be broken into three main stages: crushing and cleaning, flotation and drying, and sizing and compaction. In crushing and cleaning, raw ore is fed into large crushers to make the pieces a more uniform size. The crushed ore is fed into agitation tanks, or scrubbers, filled with a brine solution. During this process, called desliming, the mix goes through screens, cyclones, and other specialized equipment to remove clay particles, leaving behind potash and salt. In flotation and drying, we separate potash from the salt crystals. During flotation, a reagent is added to the mixture and causes air bubbles to form around the potash crystals. The crystals then rise to the surface and are skimmed from the solution by paddles, moving one step closer to a finished product. To remove excess moisture, the slurry of potash and brine is fed into large centrifuges that pull the brine away from the potash, like the spin cycle of a washing machine. The damp potash is then fed into fired dryers that take out the remaining moisture. To prepare consistently sized granules, we begin the process of sizing and compaction. Potash is sized and separated through a system of oscillating screens, sifting through the different sized crystals. Undersized crystals are pressed together, then crushed and screened again. This compaction process is repeated until the granules have a common size. At this stage, the product can be sent to warehouses, and each nutrient facility has significant storage capacity. From these facilities, plant-ready potash can be loaded into rail cars and shipped to buyers around the world. Almost all the potash we produce in Canada is exported to other countries, where it is applied to improve crop yields and quality.